Pennsylvania, weighing 230 pounds, Stevie Richards.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, Stevie Richards will give us 100% of heart in this match. We know that. We saw Richards make a gallant attempt on not one but two occasions against the undefeated Moscow and Baller. But I got to thank Nick, and I know you know Stevie very well, that Stevie Richards is more than likely the underdog in this matchup.
Well, maybe a slight underdog. I have to respect that Kendrick's intelligence. Anybody who can go out and hire his man Zeke is showing some intelligence.
And find a jacket. That retro jacket is another
The bedazzler is big this year.
Yes.
In a down economy, you got to relocate those bedazzlers, JR.
And let's not take anything away from Stevie Richards, but can Brian Kendrick maintain his role? And Kendrick very, very proficient in using the kicks to knot up the hamstrings and the quads, the quadricep muscle of a lot of bigger opponents. And we're talking about this young man's legs. Good one, those up. There I go. Brian Kendrick knows a lot of ways to break a larger opponent down.
Yeah, you remember the old saying, speed kills, and this kid is lightning quick. He knows his holds.
I knew there was a face there someplace in that hair in the arms of Stevie Richards. He'd get his head kicked off. A little Camel Clutch-like action there before those cross faces came pounding in.
Kendrick really, Kendrick really seems to relish this not the new attitude, but the spotlight on his attitude. Likes the crowd booing him.
And now the hook of the leg after the unique offense, and Brian Kendrick has wrestled thus far a mistake-free match.
How about it, Stevie? What are you saying there? How about it?
And Boston Crab in Harrison, or near Harrisonburg, here in Hershey, PA.
He's saying no in there. How about it, Stevie? Talk to me.
I think you're confusing Harrisburg and Mechanicsburg, JR. If Brian Kendrick's so intelligent, why doesn't he own a barbecue restaurant, and why hasn't he written a number one bestseller, huh?
Well, let's don't get on the wrong side of his man Zeke, you know what I'm saying. Look at that kick. Again, no wasted motion by Brian Kendrick. Kendrick very proficient. We've seen it even more and more using his kicks instead of his fists and using them very effectively. And the cover here, how long has Stevie Richards been off his vertical base?
Most of the match. I have to tell you from experience that when you wrestle a guy like the Kendrick, an annoying guy, a guy that you deep down don't like, it can throw you off your game.
Now, you were on the money about 3 weeks ago when you said that you had never really liked Brian Kendrick. If you thought he'd always been a jerk, I certainly wasn't aware of that, his personality.
Well, he was always running to the ring and always wearing that little mask and with the tent-like shorts. You didn't really have a chance to focus on his personality.
Kendrick made a mistake.
Get him, Stevie.
Stevie Richards is retaliating with kicks of his own.
Oh, yeah.
Hard shot to the spine. And Kendrick not the only man that can kick the cover. And a near fall by Stevie Richards, who just exploded after Kendrick made one small error. Another mistake. This time it's a fatal mistake.
So close, and I can't help but wonder what a defeat like that at the hands of Richards would have done to the mental makeup of the Kendrick.
Well, the Kendrick is trying to roll out of bounds, and referee Nicky Henson. Well, big Zeke just... Kendrick did hit the contract. Zeke just caught the Kendrick in midair.
And the welts on the back of the Kendrick. He really laying in those boots and chops.
And
no, don't turn around. There's that injured throw to Stevie Richards.
Stevie Richards took his eye off his opponent, put him on Big Zeke, and the Kendrick just hit the Kendrick. Ladies and gentlemen, we're seeing something evolve here on Friday Night SmackDown with the Brian Kendrick and his man Zeke.
Yeah, I was impressed by Richard, but even more so by the Kendrick. He took one moment of opportunity, and capitalized. That's what he needs to do. Get to the top of SmackDown.
Brian Kendrick blowing disingenuous kisses. Hey, wait a minute.
Come on, Zeke.
Good Lord. back. Big Zeke with a bone breaker. Look at this rack. The strength of Ezekiel. Just toying with Stevie Richards. Brian Kendrick has a very dangerous and deadly associate.
And the phrase taking up with Zeke is a whole new meaning, JR.
Brian Kendrick very proud of his results here, winning again. But look at this. The Kendrick.
It is called the Kendrick.
And then after the match, ladies and gentlemen, we saw just how strong, just how deadly, just how powerful Ezekiel is. Our first time to see the brute force of this man. Using that overhead backbreaker effectively. And Ezekiel's presence has already built a new equity in Brian Kendrick. And ladies and gentlemen, you talk about high stakes. Can Jeff Hardy do it tonight? Can he pull off one of the biggest upsets ever when he faces the giant Great Khali? Khali. Look who's joining us. The controversial one himself. Edge.
In the ring with Ranjan Singh from India, standing over 7 feet tall, weighing 420 pounds, the Great Khali.
The 7'3" Great Khali is the number one contender for the WWE title and will meet the game at SummerSlam. A man that has a 16-inch fist, an 84-inch chest, and wears a size 6X shirt. It's what I'd call back in Oklahoma a mountain of a man.
Well, Triple H is going to have his hands more than full of this monstrous Great Khali.
And Triple H and the Great Khali have never met before, but they'll meet at SummerSlam, and the stakes will be high.
Weighing 225 pounds, Jeff Hardy!
Jeff Hardy's entire focus must be on that giant of a man, the Great Khali.
And speaking of focus, JR, I have to believe that somewhere, in some corner of the building, the game, Triple H, is taking notes on the Great Khali.
Well, you know the Cerebral Assassin will have the best game plan possible going into the 21st SummerSlam. But will it be enough? Physically, can it be enough? Talking to Ranjan Singh, who's at ringside, the handler of the Great Khali, telling me today about the amazing, extraordinary hand strength of Khali.
It appears to me like Khali is making fun of the relatively small size of Jeff Hardy.
Jeff Hardy's no small man. But remember, Khali is 7 feet, 3 inches tall.
Yeah, everything is relative when it comes to the size of Great Khali. It's great to see Ranjan Singh back at the ringside, isn't it?
Oh, it really is. So happy he's there.
Absence does make the heart grow fonder.
And Jeff Hardy normally flies first class, just got grounded with a pachyderm-like strength of the Great Khali.
Earlier tonight, we saw an outward display of aggression from Jeff Hardy, the likes like we've never seen. I wonder if he's going to be able to channel that aggression into this matchup with Khali.
And even if Jeff does, isn't enough looking at the size advantage that the Great Khali possesses. The Great Khali, a former heavyweight champion of the world. He is the pride of India. As we said before, this man is to India what Yao Ming is to China.